Hello everyone, welcome to Instrumentation Academy. In this video, we will discuss what is instrument calibration and how an RTD is calibrated. Calibration of an instrument is a process of determining its accuracy. The accuracy of an instrument tends to decrease over time due to hard operating conditions, mechanical shocks, or exposure to extreme temperature or pressure. In order to be confident in the accuracy of the measurement that the instruments produced, the calibration of instruments need to be carried out on a regular basis. Calibration is done by comparing the measurements of two instruments in which the measured value from an instrument under calibration is compared with the measurement of instrument having known and high accuracy. Why do we need to calibrate instruments? In a process plant, the control system controls the plant. The control system obtains measurement data from various instruments in the plant and controls the plant based on this measurement data. So if the measurement data is incorrect, the controlling of the plant will also be incorrect. So from this we can say that in a process plant, everything is based on measurements. And therefore the measurements done by the instruments in the plant should be accurate to be able to control the plant properly. So to maintain the accuracy of the measurements, calibration should be done regularly. The only way to check that if an instrument's output accurately corresponds to input is to give that instrument a non-input value while measuring the corresponding output signal values. For this, a process calibrator is used. Calibrator should be more accurate than the instruments you calibrate with it. Calibrators are calibrated regularly by more accurate reference standard maintained by National Metrology Institute, and after calibrating by more accurate standard, these institutes issue a 1-year valid certificate for calibrators. Before starting any calibration, the validity of the calibration certificate of a calibrator must be assured. There are different types of calibrators available in the market. The type of calibrator selected for a particular calibration task depends on the type of sensor to be calibrated, the environment in which it is to be calibrated, and the required accuracy of the calibration. Some of the commonly used calibrators are dry block calibrator, pneumatic calibrator, signal reference calibrators, etc. Consider that we need to monitor temperature in a tank. For that, we have bought a new resistance temperature detector, or RTD. As you know, RTD is a temperature sensing device which gives resistance as output and whose resistance increases with increase in temperature. The output of this RTD may be or may not be accurate. To confirm the accuracy of the RTD, calibration is done. To perform RTD calibration, usually dry block calibrator or temperature bath is used as calibrator. RTD which is to be calibrated will be placed into the temperature calibrator. The calibrator maintains a fixed temperature which is set by the user, and so the output resistance of the RTD changes with respect to the temperature of the calibrator. Now a multimeter in resistance mode is connected between the terminals of the RTD to read the output resistance value of the RTD. This output resistance value is compared with the standard resistance versus temperature chart provided by the manufacturer to find the exact temperature detected by the RTD. The user now makes a record by entering this value of temperature detected by the RTD and the temperature displayed on the calibrator. This procedure is repeated for few other set of temperatures within the range for which the RTD is used and the readings are recorded. If both the temperatures displayed are same or within acceptable deviation from the standard value, the RTD is considered to be accurate. A final document called calibration certificate is prepared, which contains list of calibration standards used for the calibration, any data resulting from the calibration date, and possibly pass or fail statement for each measurement results. This is how a typical RTD calibration is done. During calibration of an instrument, the readings or output of the instrument to be calibrated is checked at several points throughout the calibration range of the instrument. The calibration range is a range of values over which the instrument has been tested. The calibration range is different from instrument range. Instrument range refers to the range within which the instrument has capability to measure. Consider that the nameplate of a pressure transmitter shows an input pressure range from 0 to 750 psig and an output of 4 to 20 milliamps. This means that the instrument has capability to handle an input of 0 to 750 psig and produce corresponding output. This range is known as instrument range. Now consider that we need to use this transmitter for an application where we need to give an input of 0 to 300 psig and get an output of 4 to 20 milliamps. Here calibration is done only for 0 to 300 psig. This range is known as calibration range. Calibration range is defined by the zero and span values. The zero value is the lower end of the range and the span value is the algebraic difference between the upper and lower range values. Now let's check what is the zero value and the span value of the transmitter having a calibration range of 0 to 300 psig. Here the lower range 0 is the zero value and the span value is the algebraic difference between the upper and lower range values. That is, here it is the difference between 300 and 0, which is 300 psig. By this we come to the end of this video. If you like our video, please click the like button below and make sure to click the subscribe button and the bell icon also so that you can get notifications of our further videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.